Representative Orcutt, last Friday you led a Republican effort in the House Finance Committee to oppose $4.5 billion in new tax increases, including a new capital gains income tax, a B&O surcharge on the income from various services, a new graduated real estate tax, and changing the non-residential retail sales tax exemption to an annual remittance. Tell us what happened there.
Well, unfortunately, all of our attempts to either squash the proposals or amend the proposals were rejected on an 8-5 and 9-4 vote. The bills were advanced. They failed to listen to the fact that the capital gains income tax is an income tax and is prohibited by our Constitution. They didn't listen to the impact that increasing taxes would have on some of our rural communities when we're trying to get medical professionals to leave the cities and come out and set up in these rural communities, making it easier for people to visit a doctor rather than having to travel many, many miles to get to one. And also, it's making it more cumbersome for people to take advantage of the out-of-state sales tax exemption, which means now we're going to start losing business at our retailers. And that's going to be an impact to retailers throughout Southwest Washington. And I'm very concerned about that.
On a different topic, yesterday the governor signed House Bill 1801 into law. You were the prime sponsor. Tell us why this bill is so important to so many families.
Well, this addresses the Greenwood Cemetery issue that we've been dealing with for a number of years. It makes it very clear that people have the right to go in to do burials. If they have proof that they have a plot, they have the right to enter for that purpose, to bury someone. They have the right to go in and visit graves of people that are buried there, their loved ones that have passed on. But it also gives a chance for the city to get a certificate to go in and do the maintenance. It's something that was only afforded to nonprofits, but we didn't have any nonprofits stepping up. So this will allow the city to go in and do the cleanup and do the maintenance in there and restore Greenwood Cemetery and keep it in a condition that's respectful of those who are buried there and respectful of those who are going to visit those who are buried there. Very important to many, many people in our area.